Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode and the following three episodes, I will investigate how you can create new file templates in Qt Creator. That is, when you press Control N, a dialog, just like this one here, will show up. And observe how in my dialog it says KDAB viewer dashlet at the bottom. I'll bet you that your Qt Creator, at least not yet, says that. When I choose that item, you can see in the configuration dialog here now that there are other things that I ask for than what the usual file new asks for, namely the dashlet path. In this episode and the following three, I will teach you how you can create those file templates with your data yourself. Step number zero, before you do anything, you need to start Qt Creator using a command line switch called minus custom wizard minus verbose. If you don't, you will not see any debug output at all. So better do that and observe my Qt Creator starting up now. In the general messages, it prints out a lot of stuff here. And let me just scroll to the very top. Here you can see there's some important stuff, but let's get back to that in just a second. Because step number 0.1, I don't know, you need to set a special key binding. So go to Options, Environment, Keyboard, and you search for Factory Reset. This one here, thank you for scrolling off my screen. This one here, you can see Reload All Wizards. Bind that to something that you can easily reach because you're going to press that a lot. So I bound it to Windows key F12 in my setup. The other one you need to is inspect wizard state. I bound it to Windows key F11. Do something similar. Next step, you go out here and you look at the output. So if you look here, checking C blah, 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 blah for wizards. And one of the things it checks for is my roaming data on my Windows machine here. This is the directory that it will check for my local edition. So I'll put something in that directory. God forbid, I will absolutely not start this from scratch because that is very complex. I will take one of the existing one. I'll actually take this one here, my CPP, my wizard class is CPP. Let me just show it to you, Control N. That is this one up here. That's the one that I will be basing my work off. So let me copy this directory here up to this directory. I can do that super fast. Just observe me super fast writing. And there is three files in here. I can go back and I can, let's just clear this output here. I can press Control N now. Nothing changed. What did I forget? I forgot to press the magic key. So Windows key F12. Do you see it? Let me just do it a few more times. Oh yeah. You don't see anything at this stage. What it just sets is a flag behind the scenes saying, okay, forget all about the data that I cached from loading in those wizards previously. Next time I press Control N, observe this down here, Control N, and all of a sudden it loads it in. And now, yes, I did this mistake on purpose, just to show you what went wrong, because otherwise you're going to do it and you'll be sitting there for half a day wondering why does nothing. Let's just go over here. Remember I called it KDAB viewer, so let's just filter. It actually did look into this and it found the wizard.json, but still nothing. And the reason for that is that it's you can't see the difference from this one and the one that I just copied over. And this one comes from Qt installation and, well, what does this one come from mine? You can't tell the difference. So let's go and look at what does the actual file look like. Let me be the first to admit that I don't understand everything in those files, but there's a link right here where you can learn more about all of the gory details. For now, just keyword parse your way through the files That was good enough for me, at least, for most of what I'm going to show you in this and the following three videos. The top part of this file is just a description that is used in the use interface. A version number, no idea what it does. Supported project types, sorry, go look at the documentation. ID, I know what that is. That's a unique ID that it would use when loading in. And that's why we didn't see a new version, because they both had the same ID. So let's call it KDV for KDAB viewer. A dot, that is just for sorting. So if I call this set dot, then it would be at the end of my sorting. Again, you don't see this on the screen, it's just an ID. Then the category goes into the C++ category. O dot, again, for sorting. So it doesn't go on the screen either. What you'll see on the screen is C/C++. So yeah, that's how they chose to create this file format. Description. Template for KDAB viewer -lets. The display name, that's what we'll see, KDAB template. Or let's call it KDAB viewer -lets. That's it. And icon, that's the text that you'll see there. Actually, you can change it into from icon text into an icon, and then icon KDAB viewer.png. Just like a good chef, I already copied over that file into this directory, so you didn't have to see me doing the copy operation. Instead, you could watch me explain that I would do the copy operation. Wait a minute. Let's save. Let's hope that I didn't make any mistakes. Go back to Qt Creator. I don't need to restart Qt Creator. All I need to do, and let's just nuke this off here, all I need to do is press my magic key F12. That's the magic key that I set up in my settings before. And now Control N for new. And I obviously did something wrong because I don't see anything here. So fail to create icon file, blah, 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 blah. KDABViewer.png not found. Okay, so much for being a magic chef. Let me see what I did wrong here. KDABViewer.png, that went into the right directory, didn't it? KDABViewer.png. And of course, I only did all of this mistake here so that you could learn from how to debug these errors. 10 minutes later, I now learned how to spell viewer. Yes, yes, yes. I missed the E in KDABViewer, but it was just so that you could see the error message being shown there. Let's go to my Qt Creator again and magic key F12 and Control N. And now you can see that I got my KDABViewer-let here. If I choose that, yeah, it looks pretty much like what you have with the C++ because I haven't changed anything. So that's next. So what I want to do in this episode is to change the header file and the CPP file so that they do something I would like to do. And let's go back to the code. This time I'll open the file.cpp and file.h and modify those two files. Are you ready? We'll open file.h first. Calm down, breathe slowly. No reason to panic. Are you afraid of what it looks like in here? Let me handle that for you, okay? There we are. Better? See, this is just a template file. What I really would like it to do look like is like this. That's what I have in my project. I have pragma once instead of the ifdef and whatnot. I include these two files here. I have a UI here with my class. That's my -let. I have other stuff in here. It is that scary. First of all, I would like, instead of saying my -let, I would like it to have my class name. And I'll show you how to do that. Super, super simple. I'll search for my -let here. In my case, I will do search and replace, and I'll simply replace that with CN like this. Yes, 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 and yes. What did you just do there, Jesper? Again, don't worry. I went to the documentation, and I found that there was a bunch of keywords that you can replace it with. Let me just save this one for you here. Saved. Go back to my Qt Creator. In my Qt Creator, magic key F12 again. And now Control N. I will choose my KDAB viewer dashnet. And I could go to the documentation. I know that you are scared of the documentation, just like all of us. So in that situation, magic key F11 for me, that was the other keys that I set up. And what you'll see now is the keys and their value that they evaluate to. And here you can see that there is, Jesper, you forgot. We'll go back. I need to type something in here. What do you say? Bah, yeah, that's a great word. And now magic key for F11. And you can see that it says CN, bah. Let me go back again. Bah, it's actually name boo, well, name space boo, :, class bah. Windows key F11. You can see the class here is namespace boo :, class bar, while the class name itself is class bar. So CN, that is the variable that I can expand in my header files. And if I press OK now, and I will save it to my documents, that's going to be great to have those files there. Next and finish and so on. You can see my header file over here, my header file. Looks like that. Class, class bar, not the namespace part, because that's, of course, I should have the namespace part around it here, but I'll leave that as an exercise for you to do that. But here you see class, class bar, and class bar, class bar. Pretty simply, that was the header file. We also have the source file, but I'll go ahead and do that while you continue on with your regular daily work. However, observe, we didn't really need to learn a lot of magic for this to work out. Actually, it was so trivial that all we needed was two key bindings. We needed to press the Windows key F11 at that point so we could see the variables to expand. And we needed to know where the files were. This will help you 90 to 95% of the way. But if you're more curious, there is three more videos. In the next one, I will add another file to my files generated. In the video following that, I will set up so that we can query in our file new dialog for the dashlet path. That was one of those variables that were in there. And then finally, in the third one, I'll do some cleanup and I will move it from the C++ to the Qt category. Not entirely trivial, but I'm getting ahead of myself now. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. Please do subscribe to our videos so that you will know exactly when that new file template video comes out.